My name is Muhammad Javed, and my question is, why can't God not take a human form?
The brother asked the question that why can God not take a human form? If God wants, He can take a human form. But the moment He takes a human form, He ceases to be God. Because God and man, they are two opposites. Man is mortal. God is immortal. You can't have a mortal and immortal person at the same time. Man has a beginning. God has got no beginning. You can't have a person who has a beginning and no beginning at the same time. Man has an end. God has no end. So you can't have a person having an end and no end at the same time. It doesn't make sense. So you can't have a God-man. You can either have God or you can have man. You can't have a God-man. So if God takes human form, He ceases to be God. He becomes human being. Because man requires to eat. God does not require to eat. The Quran says in Surah An'am chapter 6 verse number 14 that He feedeth everyone but doesn't require to be fed. The human beings, they require rest. They require sleep. The Quran says in Ayatul Kursi, chapter number 2, verse number 255, which was also recited by the Qari, Brother Ashraf Muhammadi, Allahu la ilaha al-hayyul qayyum, la ta'khudhu sinatun wa la nawm, lahu ma fis samawati wa ma fil ard. Allah, He is one and only. The self-existing, the eternal. No slumber can seize Him, nor does He require sleep. To Him belongs everything in the heaven and the earth. Therefore, God, when He takes a human form, He ceases to be God. You can't have a God-man together. And if a God becomes human being and gives up His quality and becomes man, why should you worship a human being? Because He has same power than you and me. People will want to worship you and me also then. What is the use of worshipping a person who has same powers like you and me? And later on, if someone tells me this same human being became God, it's not possible. If human beings can become God, even you and I would become God tomorrow. Therefore, if Allah wants, He can become a human being. But He'll cease to be a God. Therefore, Allah will never want to become a human being. Allah can tell a lie if He wants. But He will never tell a lie. Because to lie is ungodly. The moment He lies, He ceases to be God. Allah can do injustice if He wants. But He will not. Because to do injustice is ungodly. As the Holy Quran says in Surah Nisa chapter 4 verse number 40 that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is never unjust in the least degree. So if He does injustice, He ceases to be God. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if He wants, He can make a mistake. But He will not make a mistake. Because to make mistake is ungodly. The Quran. Says in Surah Taha chapter number 20 verse 52. That Allah does not make mistake. Allah doesn't err. So if He makes a mistake, He ceases to be God. Allah can forget if He wants. But He will not forget. Because forgetting is an ungodly act. The Quran says in Surah Taha chapter 20 verse 52. Allah doesn't make a mistake, neither does He forget. The moment He forgets, He ceases to be God. Therefore, the Holy Quran says, Inna Allah ala kulli shayin qadir. Verily Allah has power over all things. In several places, in Surah Baqarah chapter 2 verse number 106, in Surah Baqarah chapter number 2 verse number 109, Surah Baqarah chapter 2 verse number 284, Surah Al-Imran chapter number 3 verse 29, Surah Nahl chapter 16 verse 77, in Surah Fatir chapter 35 verse number 1, Allah says, Inna Allah ala kulli shayin qadir. For verily, Allah has power over all things. But Allah only does godly things. He doesn't do ungodly things. Because Quran says in Surah Buruj, chapter 85, verse number 16, Allah is the doer of all He intends. Whatever Allah intends, He can do. But He only intends godly things. This theory of God becoming a human form is called as anthropomorphism. Almighty, God taking a human form. And most of the major religions, sometime or the other, they have in their philosophy that God has taken a human form. Some religion once, some several times. And they have a very beautiful logic for that. They say that God Almighty, He is so pure, He is so holy, He doesn't know regarding the feelings of the human beings, regarding the shortcomings, the difficulties a human being can have. He is so holy and pure. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't know how does a human being feel when he's hurt. How does he feel when he gets into trouble? So therefore, God Almighty came in the form of a human being in this world to set the rules for the human being. On the face of it, very good logic. But I tell these people that if I manufacture a tape recorder, do I have to become a tape recorder to know what is good or what is bad for the tape recorder? No. I just write an instruction manual that when you want to play the audio cassette, put in the cassette, press the play button. When you want to stop, press the stop button. When you want to fast forward, press the FF button. Don't drop it from a height, it will get spoiled. Don't immerse it in water, it will get damaged. I write an instruction manual. I don't have to become a tape recorder to know what is good or what is bad for the tape recorder. Similarly, when Almighty God is our creator, He doesn't have to become a human being to know what is good or what is bad for the human being. He sends an instruction manual. And the last and final instruction manual for the human beings is the Holy Quran. The Holy Quran is the last and final instruction manual for the human beings, the do's and don'ts for the human. Beings, and He need not come down in this world as a human being to give us the instruction manual. What does He do? He chooses a man amongst men to deliver His message, whom we call as messengers or prophets, who He communicates on a higher level through the revelation. It is so clear cut to any logical person that God Almighty cannot take human form. Any fool can also understand. That's the reason the Holy Quran says in Surah Baqarah chapter 2 verse number 18, Summum bukmun umyun fawmla irjiyun. The deaf, the dumb, the blind, they will not come to the true path. And the Bible gives the same message in the Gospel of Matthew chapter number 13 verse number 13, seeing they see not, hearing they hear not, neither do they understand. Rig Veda also gives the same message in book number 10, chapter number 71, verse number 4, that though they see the words, they see it not. Though they hear the words, they hear not.